Welcome to Mind Pump TV. I'm Adam Schaefer. Today, you guys, I'm gonna go over some of the coaching cues, some of the best coaching cues that I've given clients over the years of personal training for the bench press. Bench press is actually one of the hardest exercises to feel the right muscle groups working. And the reason why that is most people suffer from what we call upper cross syndrome, which just means your shoulders are rounded forward and you have forward head. So it makes this exercise really difficult to feel it where you're supposed to. Now, if you're doing it properly, you'll feel it in your chest. Most common areas where clients, when they first try this exercise out, they feel a lot in their shoulders and their arms. That tells me that what's happening is when you're pressing, you're rolling the shoulders forward. So you're gonna see when I give the coaching cues today, I'm gonna keep telling you about retracting the shoulders. This is what I mean by that. So you're gonna see when most people are, this is their posture, and I need you to be in this position while you bench press. And notice even when I press my arms forward, I don't allow my shoulders to roll forward. That's what's gonna naturally happen if you're not mentally thinking about keeping your shoulders in that retracted position. This is really common, and so it's important that you put emphasis on squeezing the shoulder blades, keep them squeezed even when you press with your chest. You know you'll be doing it right because you'll feel it all in your chest. So you have four major points of contact. Your feet being the first ones, probably one of the most overlooked ones. You see people put their feet up in the bench or elevate their feet. This is not a good idea. A lot of your driving force will come from your feet. So your first point of contact is gonna be your feet. Your next point of contact is gonna be your low back or your butt. The next point of contact is the upper back. And then the last one is your head. Now, where there's a lot of controversy is on this the arch in your low back. This is actually something that you should have a natural arch in that low back. In fact, one of the positions that we're going to get into is we're gonna take the shoulders and we're gonna retract them all the way back. And you're gonna notice that's gonna create an even larger arch. Now, this is something that seems to be controversial for some people, but this is something that you actually want to have. As long as that back is, or that low back or butt is on the bench, your upper back and your head is there. This is the position that we wanna be. We don't wanna be excessively overarching, but when we take the shoulders and we retract, so squeeze them back together, it's gonna create a very natural arch in the low back. That's where we wanna start off for your four points of contact. So when it comes to hand placement on the bar, there's not a wrong or a right way to do this. But when you're first starting out how to learn how to bench press, a good place to start is if you take your hands and you drop them straight down. And what I'm looking for is to see this kind of a 90 degree bend in my elbow. So where would my hands be? Now I'm a taller, wider guy. So obviously where I grab the bar is different where a probably shorter guy is gonna grab the bar. So what I'm looking for is that 90 degree bend in the elbow, and then I'm gonna go right up to the bar. Now there's normally lines on the bar, so when I look up at the bar, that looks like my index finger is gonna go right about the grip. Now that's gonna be unique and different to every single person, but this is a good place to start for your standard bench press. Now there are benefits to going wide and narrow, but a good place to start is right at that 90 degree mark. And then I'm gonna grab hold of the bar. I like to take the index finger, I line it up using that line on both sides, I wrap around, get a good grip. You wanna wrap your thumbs around the bar and then lift off. So now we're gonna talk about bar path. Now before we get into bar path, there are some cues that I always like to tell my clients when they're doing a bench press. Now we do everything in front of us, so it's really common that once you grab hold of this bar with all this weight and you start to press, that you lose that natural arch and the retraction of the shoulders. This is very important because when you press naturally, your shoulders roll forward, and we wanna keep that from happening. So before we even grab this bar and focus on the bar path, we wanna make sure that these shoulders are pinched back and that we maintain that. So even when I lift the bar off, I don't want that to flatten out. So I lift the bar off, I got myself lined up, and then the bar path that I'm looking for is I want that bar to come down, lined up right about to where my nipple line is. And then I press right back up. I have just a slight bend in my elbows. I'm not completely locking out on the joints because when you lock out, that's also gonna roll the shoulders forward. I wanna keep those shoulders rolled back, a slight bend in the elbows, and then I slowly come down, right down to about where my nipple line is, and then I press right back up. So now I wanna talk to you guys about generating power, bracing your core, and then how you breathe properly on the bench press. So again, the most important piece, what we started with the points of contact, I wanna make sure My feet are on the ground. And where your feet are placed is gonna be different and individualized for every person. Some people feel more comfortable with your feet out in front of you a little bit. Some like to peel it back. Some like to be more neutral. The point is that they're firmly planted on the ground because a lot of your power is gonna come from the feet, even though we're bench pressing. I know that seems weird, but you generate a lot of your power from the legs, and this is how. So we've got our 4 points of contact, the feet, the butt, the upper back, and the head. And I'm gonna get into this position where I grab my bar, and when I grab the bar, I'm going to tighten my abs up. So you obviously can't see me doing it, but I'm bracing like as if I'm trying to fart. So I'm squeezing my abdominals. I come down at the bottom, and then when I go to drive up, it comes from my legs. So my legs actually will flex, my abs are staying tight, and then I press up. Now, when you talk about breathing, when I come down, I'm breathing in, and I've got my brace in my core, and I exhale out as I come up. I breathe in. As I come down, I brace my core, my abs, drive through my legs, I press up. Come down in, breathing in, bracing my core, driving through my legs, press up. And that is how you generate a lot of power for your bench press. Listen, if you guys liked that video, it helped you out, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and share the video. If you had any questions regarding the video, just leave in the comments below. We'll be coming back periodically and answering your guys' comments. Also, if you guys want more information regarding on how to build a chest, we actually have a free guide that we created for you. Just click the link below.